Hello and welcome to my channel. Today I've got a tutorial for you on something that was starting out. Well, I started out wanting to do something wearable and colorful, and then a cut crease happened and I still think it's kind of wearable, but I just really wanted to do something colorful. So we have color on the face, color in the background, color on the clothing, color on the nails. I'm just so ready for springtime, basically. That's really what this entire tutorial was inspired by. So yeah, let's get on with it. Okay, I'm gonna be honest with you, I'm not really digging my hairdo today at all. Like, I kinda low-key hate it. But I spend a lot of time on it and I don't feel like doing anything else, so we're stuck with this for now. Anyway, yeah, let's just go start on the actual makeup for now. I'm gonna do my eyebrows first. It's not like turning out the way I anticipated. Like, it is, like, it's exactly as I anticipated, it just doesn't look the way I expected it to. When you get what you want, then you realize you don't actually want it. Then just priming the eyelids. I'm using the NYX base because I don't need a full coverage one this time around, because I'm gonna do something wearable anyway, I think. I'm not actually sure what I'm gonna do, but we'll figure it out. Now, what I do know already is I want to use bright colors, so I'm going to use the Jawbreaker palette by the Everystar Cosmetics. As always, you don't need to use the same products as I'm using. I will put a list below in the video description, as always. But you're just going to need some bright colors, and I think because of my shirt and my nails, I'm going to go for pink. Perhaps a bit of blue in it, and yellow too, maybe something spring-like. But yeah, first off, we're just gonna start with a transition shade. For set transition shade, I'm just using a very soft pink. Just pick a shade that's like slightly deeper than your skin tone, but not, you know, just more pink basically, but not necessarily super dark. So just going to make sure that the eyeshadow base in the crease isn't going to crease. And also make sure that the other colors are going to blend well. Doesn't need to be like neat, can be a bit sloppy, doesn't matter. Just make sure it's on there. Next up, the inner corner crease is going to be pink, so I'm grabbing a darker pink on a more dense brush and just applying that. I'm being more careful on this eye than I was on the other eye, because this brush is dense and this eyeshadow is very pigmented, so if you apply too much, then it's going to be difficult to blend. A safer option is to just start somewhere and build it up slowly, instead of applying, like, you know, a completely opaque layer of color and then having to blend it out for the next 12 years. So yeah, I'm only blending until about halfway, because I do want to actually go for a blue shade after that. Like, slowly the idea of what I actually want to do is like taking form, and I am trying to keep this wearable. This is me trying to keep things wearable. Wearable for a spring party or something, probably not something office friendly, but yeah, we'll see how it turns out. Then time for the blue shades. Yeah, I'm just picking quite a bold blue and putting that in the outer corner of the crease. Basically the outer half of the crease. And I'm going to blend it together with the pink, and I'm also going to blend it together, well, together. Not together with the eyebrow, but up to the eyebrow, just wiping off my brush so I don't keep applying product. And start on blending. And once more, we'll be blending for about 5 hours. This look for so far is just mostly just a whole lot of blending. Okay, my camera just cut out for no reason. I hope it's not gonna do it again. Anyway, like, the battery is fine, it's fresh, it's new. The memory card is pretty much empty, and it can't overheat because it's really cold here. Weirdness all over the place. Anyway, we're just going to ignore it. Point being, what I was going to tell you, I'm just using a paler blue now to blend the dark blue part towards my eyebrow, because on my ghostly pale skin, the dark blue is just way too dark for me to blend together to my eyebrow, because that's just too much of a difference. Also, the color combination at this point sort of reminds me of Harley Quinn. Completely on accident, but anyway. I'm actually going to see that movie for the second time tomorrow. Like, I really wanted to go to the cinema, but the only movies they were playing were movies, well, the ones I wanted to see, actually. Either they were only playing them, like, right around supper time, which is just highly inconvenient. Or they would be not interesting to me, or they would be like, well, let me put it this way, there was one horror movie that I wanted to see, but then I looked at the trailer and it had so many cliches in it that I was like, never mind. So I decided to just go watch Birds of Prey again, because it was fun the first time, so, you know, logically speaking, it should be fun to watch it again. So, yeah. So now I'm accidentally influenced by a movie, apparently. Just putting down an eyebrow highlight with an off-white shade. And then I'm using my big fluffy blender without extra product to do some blending. Yet again. Then I just randomly decided I wanted to do a cut crease, so I'm just going to do that with a very high coverage concealer. Okay, I think wearable just went out the window, but to still sort of make it slightly wearable-ish, I'm just using a very pale pinkish nude shade, a matte one, to go over the concealer. Instead of like glitter and shimmer. I'm hoping that will save, you know, the whole effort of making it wearable. So now I'm just using an eyeliner pencil and a bit of water to make a glittery eyeshadow into an eyeliner, hopefully. And I'm applying it around the edge of the cut crease. Okay, so that's on there. I actually kind of like it. By the way, one tip just in between here. When I do something like this, focus please. I usually just go for one single corner of the eyeshadow pan to accomplish the entire like gel liner from eyeshadow result. Just so I don't drench the entire eyeshadow pan. Just, you know, it's more convenient that way. But anyway, now it's time for just a regular black eyeliner. And then I'm going to have to copy this to this eye. Which is always, trust me, the most important, but yet difficult thing to get it symmetrical with the other eye. Anyway, eyeliner first. And conveniently, my face makeup also randomly appeared while I did my other eye. No, it didn't. I figured I'd just do my foundation, concealer, and powder in that order off camera, because this is pretty intricate already for a tutorial, and yeah. I figured it wasn't very useful to show the face base. Anyway, for the bottom eyelid, I'm going to go in with a fluffy brush and a yellow eyeshadow. Do make sure whatever eyeshadow you use that it is very pigmented, so you can actually easily tell that it's supposed to be yellow and that it is not a random discoloration in the foundation. If you have about the same skin color as I do, then that's a bit of a risk with the yellow eyeshadow. Anyway, and then I'm going to go in with pretty much the same color as my shirt on a very tiny brush, and I'm pressing that between my lower lashes. Mostly focusing on the outer corner. So we get this result. And then for the inner corner highlight, I'm grabbing the same shade that I used, random piece of fabric, that I used as a cut crease liner, but then dry. It's a very nice sort of pale gold shade. I think I might actually add another highlight on top of it, because I want it to be slightly brighter. But first off, I'm just going to look for falsies first, because I want falsies, but I haven't decided on a pair yet. Then after that, mascara. After that, figure out what I want on the waterline, and then we'll move on. Okay, so this is the style I ended up with. Quite pointy, quite out there. But I think they're quite pretty and they really fit the look in my opinion. I think this is the Brave by Exo Beauty, but I'm not sure, so I'll look it up before I put it in the description. And then while the lash glue is drying, I'm just going to do my waterline. I was going to go for nude first, but then I decided I'm just going to use purple. And then some mascara to blend my own lashes with the falsies. I just decided to also show you the face makeup. I have no idea how long this tutorial is going to be, but I figured what colors will fit with this. Yeah, let's go ahead and find out. First though, I'm going to just apply some eyebrow plumper. That's like something I almost always, you know, nearly forget. Thing is, I don't want to do it directly after I do my eyebrows with the pomade, simply because then when I apply my foundation, there's going to be foundation in them, a powder in them, and they're going to get paler again, and that's annoying, so I always try to save that until my face base is at least done. Anyway, first off I'm going to do, a little bit of bronze contouring, basically. This isn't really a contour product, but I am applying it quite heavily. Like really blending it out very far from the area where I usually contour. Just because I do want some shape to my face, but I mostly just want to warm up my skin a little bit. Bangs, why are you always so annoying? For blush, I'm just going to use the same shade that I also used between my lower lashes, peachy one. If you don't put it on top of yellow eyeshadow, it turns out a lot more peach than orange. Alternatively, you could of course just use an actual blush. I just really wanted this color. And then for highlighter, I'm going to use one of which I broke the packaging. This one is by Makeup Academy. Anyway, it's sort of a purple-ish undertoned highlighter. It's really, really blinding. As always, you can't really tell on this cheekbone in my lighting, but you can see it here, hopefully. It's very, very blinding, but it's not too much, you know, like it's still wearable in my opinion. And like I said, I'm also going to double highlight the inner corner with this. Yeah, eye booger. Then setting spray while I try to decide what lip color I want. This decided we're going to go for Watermelon Soda by Jeffree Star because it's the same color as my shirt. Honest question. Does it happen to you too that like minis of any and all lipsticks always dry out way quicker than full sizes? Because I always have that issue and this one is kind of dried out too, so I'm just going to apply a little bit of gloss over top of it to mask that. Okay, I think I pretty much fixed it, so we're ready for the show part. That's the final results. So yeah, as always, I really hope you enjoyed this video. If you did enjoy it, please click the like button. It would really help me out. And if you want to see more of my videos, you can always subscribe to my channel. I upload 3 times a week. And for now, thank you very much for watching. I hope you have a wonderful day. And I hope to see you next time. Bye!